to take you down to Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner. Brought to you by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. First, a word about Horlicks to those mothers unable to nurse their babies. I'd like to remind them that Horlicks is unsurpassed as a food for bottle-fed infants. Rich in calcium, phosphorus, and vitamins, Horlicks contains the elements essential for proper body growth. Also, elements necessary for the proper development of sturdy, healthy bodies, sound bones, and good teeth. What's even more important, Horlicks is extremely easy for the infant to digest. Already containing rich, full cream milk, Horlicks does not require the addition of raw cow's milk. Hence, it can be more easily, more safely handled by the tiny stomach. Also, because it is so nourishing, so sustaining, and energy-giving, Horlicks is an excellent food drink for the nursing mother herself. It enriches and increases her milk and nourishes her baby. You can get Horlicks, you know, at any drugstore. And now, let's see what's happening down at Pine Ridge. Yesterday, just as Lum was about to confess that he instigated the whole affair of Abner's kidnapping so that in rescuing Abner, he might make a hero of himself, Abner stepped in and saved his old friend from almost certain ruination by declaring that Lum did rescue him in the face of tremendous odds. As a result, Lum is now receiving great praise from his fellow townsmen for his bravery. As we look in on Pine Ridge today, we find Lum and Cedric Weehunt over at Lum's house. Lum is talking on the telephone. Listen.
And I wouldn't go so far as to say that, hardly. It ain't nothing to make a fuss over. There's been other heroes besides me. I just seen my duty and done it. That's all there were to it. Never once thought about the honor and glory there was to it. Mom, why, they was four of them, I believe it was. Awful big men, though. No, not a thing. Just my bar fish. No, Ma, I never captured them, but I run them clean out of the country. Yes, well, whilst I don't think I deserve all the nice things you said about me, it ain't my place to stand up and argue with you over it. All right. Thank you, Mom, for calling. Goodbye. Excuse me for keeping you waiting so long, Cedric. Miss Phillips just insisted on me telling her all about the kidnapping.
Yes, Mom, that's all right, Mr. Lum. I reckon you're mighty proud to have Mr. Abner back, ain't you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I was terrible worried about him, Cedric. It's a relief to know he's back safe and soundly.
I know Miss Peabody was terrible worried about him, too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, she's tickled to death to have him back. Won't hardly let him leave the place. I ain't saw him all day.
Well, how'd you ever find out where he was at, Mr. Lum?
Oh, I don't know. Just sort of figured it out, sort of, you might say. I knowed he had to be summer, so I studied it over careful, waited and all, turned it over and over in my head. Found him by a process of elimination, you might say.
Yes, Mom. Well, did them kidnippers put up much of a fight when you went at them?
Did who?
Them kidnippers.
Nappers, Cedric, nappers.
Oh, well, did the nappers put up much of a fight?
Kidnappers is the word. Now, what was it you want to know?
I said, did they put up much of a fight, them things?
Oh, Well, yeah, at first, but never taking them long to see that I meant business. Quick as I knocked two or three of them down there, then slid into running.
Well, how many of them was there altogether?
Why, they were... Was you paying any attention when I was talking to Miss Phillips just now?
No, Mom, I was looking at these pictures in the stereoscope here.
Well, there were six of them.
Six?
And one little one.
Well, did they have any guns?
Guns? Oh, why... Yeah, sure. I think one of them had a shotgun.
Well, sure lucky for Mr. Abner when you showed up when you did, weren't you?
Oh, my, yeah. I reckon it was. See, just as I got there, they had him tied to a sawmill carriage, fixing to saw him in two. I got there just in time to snatch him off and save him from a cruel fate.
Well, my pa read a book like that once where they done that very same thing.
Yeah, I did. Well,
that makes sort of a hero out of you, don't it?
Well, Some folks would call it that, I reckon. Of course, I was risking my life to save a friend. I can't deny that.
Yes, Mom. Folks here in the community ought to appreciate what you done, too.
Yeah, I hope they do.
Wish you'd sort of call it to their attention around folks you see, Cedric. Don't look right for me to be going around telling about it.
Wait a minute. He has my ring. Excuse me just a minute. I'll see who it is.
Yes, Mom. Go ahead.
Well, on this phone, he's been ringing all morning. Folks calling up to tell me how proud they are to found Abner. Hello? This is Lum Edwards, the man that rescued Abner Peabody from the kidnappers, talking. Who? Oh, well, howdy, Sister Simpson. Yes, Mom. Oh, about that. I done forgot about rescuing him.
Well, Mr. Lum, I expect I better be getting on back to the blacksmith shop. Paul may be in need, men. I'll drop over some other time and hear some more about it.
Just a minute, Sister Simpson.
All right, fellas. Glad you come over. Come back again.
Mom?
Nothing, Cedric. Come back again.
Oh, listen.
Hello? Oh, that was just a committee come over to pin a couple of medals on me for bravery. Oh, yes, them things is nice, all right, but like I told them, ain't nothing to make a to-do over, much. Any other brave, red-blooded citizen would have did the same thing, mightn't I? Well, maybe I am too modest, but I've always followed that old Eddard saying, modesty is the best policy. Ma? Why, I just went in there and whipped them and taken Abner away from them. That's all there was to it. Ma? Oh, why, eight. That is, eight big ones and two or three little ones. Why, sure they did. Shotguns and machine guns and pistols and everything else. No, Mom, nothing but my bar fist. Well, that's nice of you to say that. Oh, well, you see, I'm getting a reward. Yes, Mom, the $100 they offered for whoever brung Abner home safe and sound. Yeah, but it was reward enough for me just to see my friend and comrade safely return to his home and farside in the arms of his loved ones. I only wish I had two lives to give to my country. No, something else I'm thinking about. Nothing. I just started to say something.
Honey, Lum, I dog it all. I've heard all day. Oh,
just a minute. I'll be down here directly, Abner. What was it you said, Sister Simpson? Oh, it weren't nothing. Just another committee come in. Well, I'm mighty proud you called. Yes, just a minute, though. Sister Simpson, Abner wants to say something to you.
Well, I don't want to talk to her.
Yes, you do, too. I want you to tell Sister Simpson how brave I am.
How brave you are?
Yeah, for rescuing you from the kidnappers.
Well, I'll talk to her, but I don't know what to say.
Yeah, here. Tell her you think I'm awful brave.
Hello, Sister Simpson? Yes, Mom? Oh, yes, proud to be back. Huh? Just a minute. Did I suffer any while the kidnappers had me, though?
Suffer?
Yeah.
Oh, why, sure you did. Yeah, they was awful mean to you.
Sure I did. They was awful mean to you.
Go ahead and tell her about me. Quit talking about yourself so much. Oh, my goodness, what will you think about yourself?
Well, what did you want me to say?
Tell her how brave you think I am.
Tell her how brave I think you are or you think you are.
Just tell her I'm brave.
Lum's brave.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, I'm for rescuing me from that kidnapper.
Them kidnappers.
How many was it?
What did I tell her? I don't know. Hang up the receiver. Wait a minute. Let me talk to her.
Yeah, here. Take it. Yeah.
Hello, Sister Simpson? Well, I wouldn't have let Abner talk to you if I'd have known you was going to brag on me that way. It's downright embarrassing to me. Yeah, that's the price a big hero's got to pay, I reckon. Well, I'm glad you called up. Well, thank you, Mom. It's nice of you to say that about me. All right. Goodbye.
What have you been telling her anyway, Lum?
Oh, I was just telling her about me capturing you from the kidnappers.
Well, now, you better tell me what you said so as I'll know, for she'll spread it all over town, tell everybody she sees.
Yeah, that's right. We've got to stick to the same story.
Yeah, folks have been asking me questions about it, and I just told them that I'd rather not talk about it. Said it was kind of a nightmare to me.
Yeah, that's the time. You keep on having nightmares, and I'll do the talking. That way we can't get mixed up.
Yeah. I just tell them that they had a handkerchief tied over my eyes and I couldn't see nothing.
That's the time. Tell them that.
Yeah, that's what I'll do. I swan, I never seen folks that excited about anything in my life. I was downtown just now, and everybody I seen wanted to stop and shake my hand, you know.
Yeah, they stopped me down there this morning, too.
Oh, yeah,
all of them. Wanted to get my
autograph. Tell me how proud they are to have me back, you know. What a brave man they think you are. Oh, my Lord, they just think you're the bravest man in the world.
What all did they say about me, Abner?
Well, I don't know what all said, that you were just a hero, that's all there was to it. Oh, a whole bunch of stuff like that.
My goodness, it's working. No doubts about it.
Oh, yeah.
Only thing, just to be right honest about it, Abner, I sort of hate to fool everybody that way. Tell them all this rigmarole. Don't feel just right about misrepresenting things.
Well, it ain't hurting nobody. It's one thing, sure.
No, it ain't hurting nobody. And it sure changed everybody's opinion of me around here, I'll say that.
Oh, my, yes.
I just don't know how to thank you enough, Abner, for what you did for me.
What I did for you.
Yeah, interrupting me yesterday when I was about to tell Dick Huddleston the truth about it. Just made a hero out of me, that's what you done.
Well, I never done it just for you, Long. I knowed if you told them that kidnapping was a fake, why, we'd both have to leave town the way they felt around here. I was thinking about myself then. I told that story to save my own hide.
Granny, that's right, ain't it? It is a saving you, ain't it?
Yeah.
Sure it is. Yeah, I've got to make out like I rescued you from a bunch of kidnappers, ain't I?
Why, sure you have, Lom.
Well, good. I'll do it then, Abner. My grannies, I'll do it. Shake hands on it. Anything to help a friend. You can depend on me anytime.
Well, Lum is certainly basking in the spotlight of popularity, thanks to Abner. And now, here's a fine tribute to Lum and Abner and the Horlicks. A letter from Mr. C.W. Pate of Long Beach, California. He says,
of all the programs coming over the radio today, I believe that Lum and Abner take the cake. The Jotham Down store in Pine Ridge is so typical of the country stores in Tennessee, the state in which I was born and raised. I also know what they are talking about when they recommend Horlicks. I raised 3 husky children solely on Horlicks the first year of their lives. For 26 years, my wife's father was dean of the medical department of a prominent Eastern university. He was a very successful specialist in children's diseases and regularly prescribed Horlicks for children and for anemic adults.
Thanks for your letter, Mr. Pate. We're always glad to hear from the many users of Horlicks. I'd like to add that Horlicks can be bought at any drugstore. This is Carlton Brickett, speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlicks, who now bid you all goodbye until tomorrow at the same time.